A very good morning to my dear students. Today we are going to begin with the next lesson of science, that is substances, objects and energy. So now take your environmental studies part 2 textbook and open page number 127 and refer the textbook while I'm teaching the lesson. So now let's begin with the lesson. So children, there is one can you tell on page number 127. They are asking us to write few lines on the blackboard with a chalk. So here on the screen you can see a person who has written few lines on the blackboard. Okay, now observe the chalk. What changes do you see in the chalk? So see, he has written the matter with the chalk. But after some time, he is unable to write further because the chalk has become blunt and thus it has become smaller. Okay. Now, I hope you have finished reading whatever is written on the board, isn't it? So now what we will do, we'll wipe the board. And after wiping the board with the duster, we will tap the duster against the table. What do you see? Yes, children, you are able to see the particles on the table which were fallen on the table after tapping the duster on against the table, isn't it? These particles are white in color, yes, because the chalk used was also white, yes. Thus, these particles were of the same color as the piece of chalk. So children, when we are writing on the board with the chalk gets rubbed against the board and thus the size of the chalk decreases. So when you write on the board, particles of the chalk get stuck to the board. And when you wipe the board, these particles come off from the board, and when you tap this duster on the table, the particles fell off from it. So from this we have learned that the chalk particle is made up of tiny particles. So now let us do one more activity. Take a small piece of candy sugar or coal. Here I have taken coal. You can also take candy sugar, and you have to pound them in a mortar. Pound means see on the screen. Okay, this is called as pounding. So when you are pounding, what do you notice, children? Yes, on pounding, coal pieces turns into powder. Is it same like chalk? As we were writing with chalk, we got chalk particles, isn't it? Means that is a powder of chalk. In the same way, on pounding coal, we got coal powder. Now if you will take candy sugar and if you will pound it, will you get its powder? Yes. So when you pound the coal or the sugar, it turns into a powder, and that is its small particles. Okay. So these are the small particles of coal what you are able to see on the screen. In the same way, here these are the particles of small particles of coal. So, in the same way, all substances what we see around us are made up of very tiny particles. Okay, so here are some powdered things what we use in kitchen. Okay, they are wheat flour, gram flour, that is besan, chili powder and turmeric powder. So, are these in powdered form? Yes, and these powdered form substances we are using in our kitchen. So other substances like wood, iron, copper also are made up of tiny particles. When we cut wood with the help of saw, we see some particles which are falling down. These particles are the tiny particles of wood. Okay. So these tiny particles are called as sawdust. Okay. So when iron or copper is made smooth with a file, we again get small particles of iron and copper which are falling down. They are called as filings. Okay, so these are the tiny particles of iron and copper. Also substances like pencil, chalk, paper, wood, wheat grains, iron, copper, coal are made up of tiny and fine particles. So the small particle of different substances that we are able to see are again made up of many tinier particles, and these tiny particles are so small that we are unable to see with our eyes, means they are not visible to our eyes. Okay, so to form a particle of any substance that can be visible to us, lack of particles of that substance come together. Yes, and then we are able to see that smaller particle. Okay, so now children, use your brain power and answer the question to me. Okay, what are the small particles that can be seen in a beam of light that enters a dark room? Yes, those are the particles of dust in the air. Do you know, all substances are made up of minute particle, and this theory was first proposed by Maharshi Kanad long ago. Kanad Maharshi was born in the 6th century BC at Prabhashetra near Soratti Somnath in the state of Gujarat. His given name was Uluk. He proposed that all things in the world can be classified into 7 categories. He was also the first to suggest that every object in the universe is made up of minute particles. He named that tiny particle Pilav. So children, just like each solid substance around us, liquids are also made up of tiny particles. So let us understand about it through the example. So there is a "Can you tell?" on page number 128. We will read that, we will understand it, and then we will answer it. Okay, so children, if there is a sudden shower and if you don't have umbrella, you will take shelter under a roof at the roadside, isn't it? Even though the rain does not fall on us directly, we get wet to some extent. Yes, so why does it happen so? Yes, the raindrops that fall on the road bounces off and breaks up into droplets. Yes, that are water droplets. Okay, and these droplets are made up of tinier particles of water, and thus we become wet. It tells us that liquids are also made up of small particles. So now use your brain power. Question 1. Make a list of all the everyday substances that we use in the form of a powder. So can you tell me? Yes, the talcum powder, what do you apply on your face? Yes, is it in a powder form? Yeah. Then I have told, in kitchen we are having different substances like turmeric, chili powder, besan, that is gram flour. Yes, wheat flour, this all are in a powder form. Then any other examples if you all are having, you can take pencil and write it down in front of this question and answer the question. So up till now we have learned that solids are made up of tiny particles and also liquids are made up of tiny particles. Okay, now let us learn that gases are also made up of tiny particles. So here are few examples, and from that examples we will understand how gases are made up of tiny particles. So children, now we will learn about how gases are also made up of tiny particles. So we will answer the question 2 from Use Your Brain Power. The question is, naphthalene balls are placed in warm cloths. After some days, why do the cloths smell of naphthalene? This happens because naphthalene is continuously being converted into smaller particles in the gaseous state. These small particles from the balls settle on the cloths, and so the cloths smell of naphthalene. Since the particles leave the naphthalene balls, the ball grow smaller in size and slowly disappears. So did you understand why the cloths smell of naphthalene? Yes, because its particles are continuously converted into gaseous state, okay, and they go and settle on cloths. Yes, so the cloths smell of naphthalene. Now the third question, that is, naphthalene balls are also placed in toilets. Why do they become smaller after few days? So here is the image. Yeah, now these are the naphthalene balls which are placed in the basin. Yeah, now they're asking us, why is this naphthalene ball becoming smaller after few days? Just now we have learned, isn't it? Why? Because the particles are leaving naphthalene balls. Yes, and as they leave naphthalene balls, the naphthalene ball is becoming smaller in size, and thus after some days it disappears. Did you understand? So from these two examples we have learnt that gases are also made up of tiny particles. Also, the size of particles of rangoli is fine like a flower. Rangoli colors are also available in the forms of grains. So now use your brain power and answer the question. Suppose you do not have rangoli powder, what things can you use as alternative? Yes, you can use rice flour as an alternative. In case you do not have colors, you can use turmeric powder or kumkum to draw rangoli.